Hello everyone, welcome to this next video in this series on blueprinting in assessment. In this video and in this session we are going to discuss about preparation of blueprint, and in the previous video Dr. Anita ma'am has covered two very important objectives of the complete faculty development program, which are they? That is, madam explained to you what are the various principles of assessment, what are the various attributes of good assessment practices and the existing assessment practice and its pitfalls, which are actually acting as a threat to the attributes of assessment. So madam has explained to you all this. Along with that, madam explained to you the weightage calculation of various content areas based on a combined weightage criteria, and that is under copyright process. Why? Because it's a novel one. It is based on clinical application of the content area. Along with that, the teaching hours allocated to that content area. Okay, so that's why it is novel and it is under copyright process. And that criteria, based on that criteria, you are going to calculate weightage in today's hands-on exercise. And after that, after you have your calculated weightage, you are going to prepare blueprint, and that will be another part of the hands-on exercise when I will explain to you what are the Excel sheet templates, and that will be based on the calculated weightage. After that, there will be a paper setting exercise which will be based on the prepared blueprint. Okay, so there is a sequence: weightage calculation, preparation of blueprint, and setting a question paper based on that prepared blueprint. Okay, now moving on to the today's exercise. First of all, you will understand, I'll just short recap of the previous video. Here it is the weightage calculation table I am going to explain to you. Here what is this? In the given Excel sheet template which I will be sharing with you, those Excel sheet template has 5 tables, 2 Excel sheet spreadsheets and 5 tables. First spreadsheet of weightage has this table which is explained on this slide. Here this table explains to you how a weightage percentage looks like when you give weightage to each and every content area, and you can have a very good overview of the complete weightage allocation to various content areas in a given assessment scope. Assessment scope, I mean to say, is the question paper. It may be for internal assessment 1, 2 or prelims. Okay, that is maybe a summative assessment also if we are going to prepare that blueprint for university paper, if you are setting university paper. Okay, so that assessment scope depends on the assessment level, and your weightage allocation also depends on the assessment scope. Okay, so here, because this is summative assessment we have taken in the project, and here paper 1 and paper 2, these demarcations have been given by MHS clearly. MHS has given, at least we are fortunate for our subject, that we have got teaching hours allocation. Along with that, the competencies are also properly grouped in our syllabus. Okay, so that is not an exercise we need to do. That is already given and we can take advantage of that. But only thing is the grouping of competencies, what has been explained to you in previous session. So you must understand what was the criteria, that was relevance, and some of the groups are already given by NMC. Okay, please refer to the previous video to understand that. Now this part of putting teaching hours and putting the expected rating based on the clinical application criteria, I will explain to you during the Excel sheet demonstration. But as of now, you can understand this is the weightage calculation table. Moving on to the next part, these are the steps of today's exercise. First is knowing the weightage of level. Weightage of level, that is recall, comprehension and application. Remember, in the previous video, what has been explained to you, for phase 1 MBBS, INAT Physio Biochem, we have to keep ourselves restricted to 50% of recall, 25% of comprehension and 25% of application. One more point I want to stress here is it is 25% application throughout MBBS across all phase 1, phase 2 and phase 3. So not more than that. Why I am stressing this point? Because over enthusiastic paper setter, if he has some clinical background, may set a question paper totally on clinical application basis. So that should be avoided. We have to restrict. We are teaching MBBS students. We are not teaching MD medicine students. Okay. So that was my point of view in telling you here that 50% recall, 25% comprehension and 25% application has to be followed. In table number 1, remember there are 4 tables in blueprint template. Table 1, 2, 3 and 4. I will explain to you in the subsequent screenshots. Okay. So first is weightage of level. Then there is table number 2, which gives you a good overview and spread of weightage in the given assessment scope. So it takes up inputs from the weightage calculation table and it shows you in the same Excel sheet template, just for overview, nothing else. The formulae in the Excel sheet template are embedded properly. There will be no technical glitch. Once you feed the value, complete table will be, you know, changing the values depending on the input. Okay. So it is table number 2. Table number 3 addresses the assessment scheme. What is assessment scheme? If you remember, assessment scheme, madam has told you that it is the total number of question, different types of question to be placed or framed in the given assessment. Okay. And marks per each type of question. So that is the assessment scheme. So please refer to it if you want to again go through that assessment scheme before we set the paper and prepare the blueprint. Then fourth table will be the most important table, that is the actual blueprint which you are going to prepare for your paper setting. Okay. So now I'll take you through the screenshots of the Excel sheet template. After that we will go for Excel sheet demonstration. This is table number 1. As I have told you that it has to address recall, comprehension and application. Only yellow cells you can change. The entries in yellow cells you can change. So you can change here 50, 25, 20. I have already mentioned it, like 50, 25 and 25. But you can change according to the need if you are using this Excel sheet template for other subjects also. But for our project, we have kept it to 50, 25, 25 because it is biochemistry and phase 1 MBBS. Along with that, the second part of this table number 1, you will see that it is a core criteria mentioned here, yes or no. As madam has explained to you in previous video that because our subject has almost all the competencies which are core, only one competency is non-core, and when we group the competencies, that non-core competency will be, you know, captured in some of the group, and that is going to be core only. So for us it is 100% core and 0% non-core competences. So we have to feed the values here in this table number 1 and move on to the table number 2. In table number 2 you will just get the overview of the weightage allocated to each and every content area and subsequently the marks also depending on the assessment scope. Okay, we will see that during the Excel sheet demonstration, but remember this table number 2 for overview. Then table number 3, which refers to the assessment scheme. Here there are two parts of the table. First part is marks for each question type and total number of questions. Here also yellow cells only can be changed. You can see here 20 MCQs, 11 BAQs, 9 SAQs and LAQs 3. I have included optional questions also because we are setting 3 LAQs out of which 2 are compulsory. So student will be attempting 2, we are setting 3. So we have to consider those optional questions also when we are giving weightage to content areas. So total marks to that paper will be 117 instead of 100. 100 marks are supposed to be attempted by student, but you know paper setter has to set for 117 marks. Okay, so understand this and put respective values. So here 3 LAQs, 9 SAQs, 11 BAQs including one optional BAQ and 20 compulsory MCQs. Apart from that, upper part of this table will be like 1 mark per MCQ, 2 mark per BAQ, 5 mark per SAQ and 10 mark per LAQ has to be entered here so that the complete blueprint, that is table number 4, will get proper inputs from your side what needs to be portrayed there and what calculation has to be done there. Okay, I'll explain to you in table number 4. This is your table number 4 and this is your actual blueprint which you are going to prepare and based on what you are going to set your question paper. Okay, so now it is empty, but you are going to input your sub questions or marks for each sub question here, and after that you'll find that it is nicely spread across the levels of domain and across the type of questions. So it will not be like that we are covering all recall in LAQs, all comprehension in SAQs and BAQs and all application based MCQ will be there. No, your paper has to be so ideal, and it is not difficult, you know, it is not difficult with this Excel sheet. Believe me, if you start doing with LAQ, SAQ, BAQ and MCQ, then you will see that it is completely spread and there is no skewness in the levels of domain and there is no skewness in the type of questions. Okay, so we will understand this during the Excel sheet demonstration. Now, can you have analogy with this these images which are shown on the slide with question paper? See here, I have shown you the jar, I have shown you some rocks, then pebbles are also there and the sand is there. I have not shown water, but water is also there. So can you have analogy? Do you understand why I have shown this? See, this jar is empty here. So this jar has analogy with this Excel sheet template, which is completely empty. And now you are going to fill it, this jar of blank blueprint template. And then the rocks are, what are these rocks? Larger size, these are LAQs. Pebbles, smaller size than rocks, these are SAQs. Then sand, we can compare sand with BAQ. And water, yes, that is MCQ. Okay, so we are going to fill that table with LAQs, SAQs, BAQs and MCQs. So, but there should be a proper sequence. If you start doing haphazardly, you will have wrong, or we can say deleterious outcomes of this Excel sheet. There has to be a proper sequence followed. So what should be the sequence? See this slide. If I start doing with LAQ, then SAQ, then BAQ and then I add water, that is MCQ, this jar is properly filled and there is no overlap and there is no gap between the LAQ, between the large stones, between the pebbles, between the sand and water. So because the gaps are filled and there is no overlap. But if you follow the wrong sequence, like here I have depicted, sand added first, then pebble, then LAQs and then water, you can see that pebbles are out. So you need to reframe your LAQs again and again, SAQs again and again to, you know, avoid the overlap or to reduce the overlap. So start doing LAQs first, then give those LAQs to the person who is framing SAQ, then those questions can be given to the person who is framing BAQ, so that he will understand, yeah, what topic these questions are asked, and we can, you know, avoid the overlap. That is the sequence which is required for implementing the blueprint. Okay, now we will move on to the Excel sheet template demonstration. We have already shared with you the Excel sheet templates. I presume that you have downloaded those Excel sheets and you have the software to open those Excel sheet templates already. Open those Excel sheets and we will discuss with the Excel sheet templates.